So now, as we have read the poem Killing a Tree, so the poet is explaining in the poem Killing a Tree that it is not an easy job to uproot a tree. Okay, only a simple jab or you can say a chop on the bark of the tree will not make the purpose complete. What it will require? It will require great force, determination, as well as continued efforts in order to take the tree out of the ground. Okay, so where it has been anchored, okay, with the soil particles firmly for so many years. So now, on the basis of this, right? So as I told you that he has personified the tree, the poet has personified the tree throughout the poem. Okay, and it is just because of this reason that he has used the word killing a tree. Why he has used the word killing a tree? Because killing a tree, actually, he wanted to relate, metaphorically, it is related to that of a human being. Because when something is killed forever, okay, it will never be revived back. It can never be, it will never come into form of life again. The thing is that the thing is almost done. Okay. So otherwise we are using the term felling the trees or cutting the trees, but here what he has used killing a tree. And it is because of this reason that he has used killing a tree. Okay. So now, coming up to the discussion of the question answers, please see in your books. So the first question is, can a simple jab can a simple jab of the knife kill a tree, and why not? First of all, yes, can a simple jab of the, no. The simple jab of a knife will not cut a tree or it will not kill a tree, because it the simple jab or a cut with a knife on the bark of the tree will let only the white liquid to ooze out, or only, and then what will happen? The new branches and new leaves will curl from the bark of the tree. It will come and the tree will again regain its form. It will soon turn into a bark, okay, and ultimately it will complete form a shady structure, formulating that of tree. So simple jab of knife or chop by the knife, it will never kill a tree. So next question is, how has the tree grown to its full size? List the words suggestive to its life and activity. Yes. How you can say? Yes, Ramni.
The untruth of the tree has led it mature to its full size. It has consumed the earth and rose above it by absorbing years of sunlight, air, and water from its roots. The words suggestive of its size and activity are as follows: grown, consuming, rising, feeding, absorbing, sprouting, pain, bleeding, heal, and expand.
Yes, very good. So the question is, how has the tree grown to its full size? So first of all, how has the tree grown to its full size? It is given in the second paragraph also. Okay. So sorry, in the first paragraph, that the tree grows to its full size because it is for years consuming the air, light, and water, and consuming all the nutrients from the soil, the tree is being turned into its complete shape. Okay. And various type of leaves or different leaves, they also sprout from the point or from the bark of the tree where cut is made. Cut or hack is given to the tree. Various leaves, they also sprout out and curl, branches they curl. And ultimately, they will ultimately bring the tree to formulate or turn to its former size, right? Then, so what are the phrases? And ultimately the tree will also formulate miniature bars. Okay, so what are the phrases? Yes, Ramneek, speak again louder.
The phrases are grown.
Yes, grown.
Consuming.
Rising.
Feeding.
Feeding.
Absorbing.
absorbing sunlight, because they are phrases, not a single word. Okay, absorbing sunlight, air and water.
Sprouting
leaves.
Pain.
And miniature balls. Okay, so these are the different phrases which are used in order to show the activity of the tree, that it is now being turned into a complete. Yes. Next question is, what is the miniature, what is the meaning of bleeding bark and what makes it bleed? So what is the meaning of bleeding bark? Okay, yes.
For an injured human, it means that when a cut is made on the bark of tree, the white liquid comes out, which provides the tree with light. The white and red liquid present inside the bark makes the tree.
Yes. So now, actually, it is metaphorically used. It is absolutely right. So bleeding bark, it is metaphorically used to the human body. Okay, like when a cut or you can say cut or you can say injury, it happens to the body of human being. What happens? Blood flows out, right? So here bleeding bark, it refers to the white liquid that oozes out, or when a cut is made on the bark of the tree. So when a small cut is made on the bark of the tree, the white liquid, it oozes out. And this white liquid is responsible for providing life to the tree. Okay, life to the tree. So it is just because of this reason that it is used as a metaphor for the life of the tree, like that of a blood is responsible for providing life to human beings. Okay. Next is, the poet says no in the beginning of the third stanza. What does he mean by this? Now let us see third stanza. So he has used no. The root is to be pulled out. So why he has used this no? Yes, because what he has explained in the first two paragraphs, because the poet has explained in the first two paragraphs about, yes, he has explained that it is not easy to kill a tree because the tree is consuming air, light and water from the earth for many years. And because of this, it has made a firm anchorage with that of what? With that of earth. The particles of the earth, they are so firmly attached with the roots of the plant or a tree that it turns out to be impossible, or it seems to be impossible to take them out completely. Okay. So for this reason, in the first two paragraphs, the poet is explaining about the various ways, like with the hack or jab of a knife, we try to kill a tree. But ultimately, what will happen? The miniature leaves, the miniature branches, okay, the miniature, yes, they curl out from the place where the cut is made. And because of this, what happened? The tree will ultimately gain its former size. Okay, it will gain its former size. Okay, but when he has come to the third stanza, so he has started it with no. It means that he is now giving a firm solution how to uproot a tree. Okay. And now he is saying whatever the ways or methods are adapted by a person to take out the tree out of the earth were not, you can say, so successful. But when he is now, what method he is giving now is quite, you can say, applicable as well as successful in uprooting a tree. As he has said in this paragraph, that the root is to be pulled out. So in order to kill a tree, what has to be done? Root is to be pulled out completely. Okay. And out of the anchoring earth, means out of the anchoring earth, means in the earth where its roots, they are so firmly bounded with the soil particles. Okay. It has to be taken out completely, and it is to be roped and tied. And for this taking out, which is not such an easy process, it has to be tied with the rope and taken out, because it requires so much of strength. Okay, so much of strength is required and it is to be pulled out and finally cut from the to cut its connection directly from the earth for where it has made its place for you so many years back. Okay, right? So Sarthak, stand up. Why the poet has said no in the starting of the third stanza? Why he said no? Next, Harsimran. Yes, Sneha, why he said no? Sit down, both of you. Why he said no? Yes, beta, why he said no? Tanishq, why he said no? Panika, why he said no?
He said no because it was a jab of the knife can't cut the tree or it is needed to be pulled out from its and from the entering earth. That is the inside the earth.
It means that he is giving a firm solution how, yes, how it can be uprooted. Okay, it is not only the cut or the jab that is being provided on the bark of the tree that will ultimately kill a tree. Okay, but ultimately what is required, it is only the a lot of strength, okay, determination, okay, and a force is required in order to take completely tree out of the ground with which it has made its anchorage by strongly bounding with the soil particles, or by strong, you can say, by the it has made its strength, you can say, deep in the inside the earth where it has been bounded with the soil particles for such a long time. Okay, the soil particles, they are so closely, you can say, bounded with the roots. Okay, and to stop that connection, it is not so easy. Okay, sit down, please. Anchorage? Like, I'm not getting. What is the meaning of anchorage earth? And earth, anchoring earth it is. Anchoring earth and earth cave. So anchoring earth means because this earth is, what is anchor? It is a, you can say, it is a, to hold a thing in a place, for example. Okay, so it is meant for holding a thing in place. Okay, so as anchoring earth, earth is acting as an anchor for the tree because the soil particles, they are firmly bounded with the roots. So they are holding that plant right at its, on its place. It is not letting it to fall or not letting it to detach from the earth. So this is anchoring. Okay, so this is the reason why it is called as anchoring earth, because it is providing firm support, protection, okay, as well as a living place for it. And in the earth cave means earth, the soil, cave means the deep inside the earth. Why deep inside the earth? Because this is the place where no light reaches. In cave, it is almost darkness. Okay, no light reaches there. So there also no light reaches. But there the plant, it stays. The roots, they stay within this earthquake for such a long time, providing strength to the plant. So this is how it is used as earth cave. Okay, metaphors they are actually. Okay. So now clear this answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Now next is, what does he mean by the strength of the tree exposed? Yes, strength of the tree exposed. Again, metaphor it is. Okay, metaphor. Yes. Yes, please.
He says that it means continuous efforts, determination, and.
But first we relate it with that of poem. Okay, so what is the meaning of this strength of the tree? Are the roots actually, okay, which are exposed, which has been bound with the soil particles for such a long time, and these roots, they have they have lived there within the earth cave for such a long time, right? Okay, and yes, and it is, and even the earth is providing an anchorage, or it is anchoring the roots for, or the plant for many years. And now what is to be done? It has to be pulled out. It has to be tied with rope in order to be taken out of that earth. Now it's clear on that side. Okay. Though the meaning of the poems, you see, it seems to be simple. It is a simple process, right? That is to tie a plant with the rope and finally to take it out. But what the poet wants to deliver is very deep. Okay, and moreover, as I told you, that ironically he has delivered the message. Okay, how ironically? Because in this poem he is telling that how to kill a tree. Okay, how a tree is killed. It means we have to tie it, we have to take it out completely. Okay, so yes, but in reality he wants to deliver the message. The trees are our lifelines. Okay, they are responsible for our existence on earth. And we should not cut trees, okay, right? So he is also giving it as a futility of, you can say, or you can say, it is our only futile efforts, useless efforts to cut, to provide a hack or jab or to harm the tree, because ultimately they will again regrow, okay, giving out sprouting leaves on the place where the cut is or jab is made, okay, right? So next, afterwards, what finally kills the tree? So what finally kills the tree? Yes, finally the tree is to be tied with rope. It has to be taken out with force. Okay, yes, and it is at that time when it has come out from its earth cave and the source of life. Okay, it is, yes, and the source of life is exposed. Okay, and at that time what happens, that the tree is finally to be on its process of death, then this tree is to be put in sunlight. Okay, where scorching, decaying, first of all decaying, first of all browning, yes, it takes place, and ultimately because of the scorching process, this, you can say, what will happen? The tree is ultimately on the way to its death, because all its connection from the mother earth, it has been snapped out, it has been broken, and finally what will happen? The tree will be killed. Okay, so clear all the questions? So you have to write down these questions in your pair notebooks, right? So after that, write down few extra questions that I'm going to discuss. Now let us discuss those extra questions. Write down first question. How has the tree?
Fourth D.
How has? The tree grown as mentioned how has the tree grown as mentioned in stanza 1? Now raise up your hands to give me the answer, please. No. On that side, Ayan and all.
The tree slowly consumes the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its
roots. Yes. Very good. Don't give collective answers. Try to speak one by one. Only then the other students will also come to know what you are going to deliver. Otherwise, when you speak collectively, nobody will get what you are speaking. Yes, Eva, speak out.
The tree takes very long time to grow. It takes the years of sunlight, air, and water to grow. Then the branches of trees come out and green.
So ultimately what happened that it will consume years of sunlight, air and water, and ultimately what will happen, and which literary device, poetic device is used? Yes, imagery. Imagery is used here. It is consuming and it has made its strong connection with that of the earth also for many years, and it has made or it has bounded firmly with that of the ground. Okay, so by consuming and by taking all these from the earth, what is happening that it is growing into its full form. So now next question is, what shall happen to the tree when it is jabbed with a knife? What happens? What happen or what shall happen? When it is jabbed with the knife, when it is jabbed yes what is what it is jabbed when it is jabbed with the knife or it is then a cut, first of all a cut is developed on the bark of the tree and bark starts bleeding, giving out white liquid to ooze out, which is actually providing the source of life or providing strength to the tree, right? And this is metaphorically compared to that of the blood of a human being. As throughout the poem, the poet has personified the tree. Okay, and he has compared it to that of human being. It is same like, yes, and it is same like as blood comes out of the body of human beings. Okay, yes, it's a source of life, like blood is a source of life for human beings, and it is because of this blood only that we human beings survive. And the poet is also saying that this white and wet liquid, it is responsible for providing strength to the plant. It is responsible for providing strength to the plant. Okay, so it is because of this reason, right, that the tree is surviving. Okay. So you have to write down these extra questions and tomorrow I will discuss more.